Hey you, yeah you, the viewer. Full disclosure here, this video is not sponsored by anyone. Hey guys, in today's Luthier's Quick Tips, I'm going to answer the question, are Stewmac tools overpriced? I know that many of you would say absolutely, they're way overpriced. Well, I have a feeling those of you who believe that are really the small shop luthiers who do some occasional repairs and maybe every once in a while build a guitar. And you might also be somebody who's always wanted to build a guitar. And then when you started to look at the tools you would need to make the guitar, you found Stewmac's website because it's going to be one of the first that pops up. They're really good at their internet marketing. And you'll see those tools and think, wow, that's really expensive. And then after doing some further research, you've probably found comparable knockoff tools on either eBay or Amazon, you know, or AliExpress, Banggood, wherever, that are significantly cheaper. And that would lead you to think, wow, Stewmac is just way overpriced. Well, in truth, you're probably not the market that Stewmac is interested in selling to. Stewmac is sort of like the Snap-on or Matco tools for guitar builders, whereas Snap-on and Matco is for automotive repair industry. However, an important difference is you're not going to see a Stewmac van driving around your community stopping at all the different guitar factories and luthier repair shops to sell the tools because there just aren't that many of them. This is an industry that is very much a small niche industry. So to provide high quality tools for those type of craftsmen and technicians means they're not going to be selling anywhere near as many tools as a Snap-on or a Matco would. So the tools are highly specialized and they require manufacturing techniques, which to some extent drives up the price. Now, as we've seen in recent years, there are a lot of foreign companies which are making knockoffs of these tools. And I'll admit, I've purchased some myself. However, what I typically find is when I use those tools in the environment that I'm working in, they don't tend to last very long. I can use them for a little while and then they end up in the trash. With the Stewmac tools, in most cases, I still have tools that I purchased 15, 20 years ago that I use all the time that show no signs of wearing out. That is what people like myself look for and expect when we purchase tools from Stewmac. Does it mean we're going to pay more money? Oh, absolutely. But I feel like I can trust what I'm getting from Stewmac and that it's going to last much, much longer than those knockoff tools. So what drives the cost of Stewmac parts and tools? Well, I think a lot of it has to do with research and development. And a lot of it also has to do with the fact that the market they're targeting is pretty small. You know, if there was a luthier on every block, then the price of those tools would probably come down out of sheer volume, but the volume just isn't there. But going back to the research and development, several years ago, Stewmac contacted me. Specifically, it was a shop assistant working for Dan Erlewine. And he contacted me to get my impressions of a product which I had been using and talking about on my YouTube channel. And we spoke for at least an hour about this product. And Dan's assistant asked me some very, very specific questions about my impressions of the product and how I use it. And then several months later, that product became available on Stewmac's website. So I have to believe that they took my input as well as their results of their own testing before they even decided whether or not to offer this product for sale on their website. And you have to understand that that type of work costs money. All that time and research, testing and development costs money. If you're a company over in, say, China, and you're knocking off a fret file that somebody else designed and built, you're not doing any sort of research and development work, which costs money. As a result, you can sell that product for cheaper. But typically what those companies do, because they're interested in profits, is they not only avoid having to spend money on research and development, but they also avoid or try to reduce and lower the cost of manufacturing the product. So they're using low-cost labor. And trust me, they've got bean counters who are looking for every way possible to bring the cost of making those tools down so that they can maximize their product. The end result, a tool that's made with poor quality materials and poor manufacturing techniques, which ends up in a tool that's just not going to hold up as long as a Stewmac tool would. So you have to take that into consideration as a big part of the cost of Stewmac tools. Okay, so let me recap. When you purchase a tool from Stewmac, what you're paying for in most cases is the cost of research and development, the testing, that sort of thing, as well as Stewmac's reputation. And that reputation is based on a desire for that tool to perform at a certain level and to last for a long time. However, when you're purchasing a knockoff from somebody else, they're not spending a dime on research and development, and they really have no reputation to protect, because in most cases, you have no idea where that tool was manufactured. There's no brand name or corporate name associated with that tool. So they could care less about protecting a reputation. And typically companies that work that way are interested only in driving up the profits by driving down the manufacturing costs. So the end result is you have a tool which is made as cheaply as they can possibly get away with. As a result, you end up with a fret crowning file that simply is not going to perform and last as long as the similar item that was developed and tested by Stewmac. Fortunately, there are some bargains to be found on Stewmac's website. You just got to know what to look for. You think consumables, stuff like sandpaper, masking tape. And a product in particular is 3M's 216U Free Cut Gold Sandpaper. Normally, when you purchase this product from another source, you have to buy it in bulk quantity. But on Stewmac's website, you can actually purchase individual sheets. You can buy, you know, however many sheets you need of each specific grit designation. So you need one sheet of 400 grit, you can order one sheet of 400 grit. You need three sheets of 800, you can get three sheets of 800. The same is also true with the micro mesh sanding abrasives. You can purchase individual sheets of just the grit designation that you need. And that makes it really convenient for small shop luthiers and guitar repair techs who don't need large quantities of sandpaper. Now, another product that I like to use from Stewmac is their double-sided sticky tape. The reason is when you do research into trying to find the right kind of double-sided sticky tape, you'll notice that there is just a huge variety of different kinds of double-sided tapes that are out there. The question is, which one works best for luthiers and guitar repair people? And Stewmac has done the research and tested several products out, and what you see on their website is what they found works best for luthiers and guitar repair techs. Now, they offer a standard adhesive as well as a heavy duty adhesive, and I typically use just the standard adhesive. And this is a roll that I've been working on for the past couple of years, so it lasts a long time. And that's what's critical, because you'll notice the price of these rolls is fairly high, which is one of the reasons why so many folks turn to that kind of sketchy method of using masking tape and CA glue. This product works much better because the tape is extremely thin, so you don't have issues with the tape being too thick, and that's especially important when you're doing CNC work and you need to attach pieces of wood to the wasteboard with double-sided sticky tape. Now you're probably wondering, has Stewmac ever made any bad tools? Well, of course they have. I remember one item that they sold, which I don't think they sell anymore, at least I haven't seen it on their website. It was a masking film that had slots cut in it that correspond to the frets on a fretboard. So you could lay this masking film over your fretboard, and that would mask off the fretboard itself while leaving the frets exposed so you could do fretwork. And it was just, the idea was a fast way to mask off your fretboard instead of having to use masking tape. And I remember seeing that product years ago and thinking, that's a great idea. That could save a lot of time. But then it disappeared from the catalog. And I think the reason was is because I'm sure that folks had difficulty with different size frets and things like that made it so this product wasn't as useful as one would have thought. And I'm sure that manufacturing it was a bit of a challenge as well. So they've gone back to offering the three different sizes of masking tape, which I think works a lot better. So yeah, they do make some products that don't live up to expectation. Now you're probably also wondering, is Chris some sort of a Stewmac fanboy? Yes and no. When a company sells me a tool that I find useful, that I rely on a daily basis, that I know I can count on, I'm sold. And I'm going to recommend it, and I'm going to rely on it and brag about it every chance I can, because it's so rare anymore in this day and age that we can find tools that always work no matter what. And, you know, it's just like when you buy a router. Sure, you can go down to Harbor Freight and pay under $50 for a router, although I think that's probably no longer the case. It seems like their product line is changing. Or you can go out and buy a nice Bosch or Makita or DeWalt router, but you're going to spend at least double the price, maybe even more. In the end, it's you get what you pay for. And if you're only going to build one guitar in your entire lifetime, you might not want to go out and spend $125 for a fret crowning file when you can buy one for, you know, $50 on eBay or whatever. You'll use it once and probably never touch it again. But if you're relying on these tools to do the kind of work that your customers are going to judge you on, you might want to consider purchasing better quality tools. So at any rate, I hope this video gives you a little bit of food for thought when it comes to the price of Stewmac tools and no, the price for all luthier tools for that matter. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button if you don't already subscribe. Click the bell for notifications. If you want to show some support for this channel and, you know, maybe give me a little financial bump, head over to eGuitarPlans.com, purchase a plan for a guitar or for the tools that I use. And even if you don't make the plan that you purchase, just know that your purchase is helping to support this channel. Until the next episode, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you soon.